Previously, and say it elsewhere.
I'm Dr. Paxton.
Hey, how you know so much about birds, Ralph?
I am a bird, and now you walk back into my life, and it's like you never left.
Until we meet again, mon petit chou-fleur.
Oh, Dr. Bullfinch.
I will not have this man running around here playing doctor.
Tonight, and say it elsewhere.
Call the code, get an OR ready, tell him gunshot wound to the chest like you wouldn't believe.
It's 10 years, Nance. I mean, I've changed.
So have I. This was 10 years ago. I'd jump into bed with you right now.
He's not going to make it through tonight, Jack.
You mean you're not going to be a bird anymore? That's right. I'm going to be a human 24 hours a day, every day.
This boy is dead and gone.
He's not dead till I say he's dead.
Only time, Jan.
They really think that's going to save him?
Yes.
You think I'm going to jump, don't you?
Come on, Ralph.
I stand right there, Hugh.
Gave you the 50 cents.
Yeah.
And she says they all did. Oh, you know Mrs. Wilder? The one recovering in the burn unit?
Yeah, what about her?
Okay, she found her husband in bed with another woman.
Working can wait. This is paradise.
So what does she do? She's a real Einstein, this woman. She gets a gallon of gasoline, she douses them all with it, lights a match, and blows them all up. Take it easy, fella. So flash forward to the burn unit, okay? They're all bandaged up. They're all in these big dressings. I look like enormous cookie monsters, okay? And they just start wailing on each other.
Who?
Mrs. Wilder and the woman she found in bed with her husband.
Having no work to do.
They're in the same room together?
Right next to each other, beating each other up. Are you listening to my story?
Of course, sir. Like, I'm simply recapitulating. It's a rhetorical device.
His mind somewhere else. Dr. Paxton.
Oh, come, come, Dr. Samuels. You think we haven't noticed the glazed look, the heavy breathing?
Not to mention the fact you've been walking around here like Secretariat after he's put out the stud.
Or how your obnoxious, detached, patronizing manner melts into a rabid sexual yearning every time she enters the room. It's really quite touching for someone your age.
I haven't the vaguest idea of what you're talking about, Fiskus.
The truth. Wouldn't you like to take a tumble with Nancy Paxton?
Raise a nickel.
A nickel?
That's right.
I see your laxative, Lyle, and I raise you two firemen. You mean to tell me that you're here of your own free volition on a Saturday night?
Certainly.
Yes, I'm sure the fact that Dr. Paxton is on call has nothing to do with it.
You're a nice hand, Sherlock. You want to be a surgeon?
What's the limit?
Morphine. Anything over the counter goes.
You mean I have to explain why I want to play cards with my colleagues every Saturday night?
With your track record, Samuels? Yeah.
Listen to this. I'm going to sit here and take this kind of abuse from someone who has the nerve to raise me a nickel. A nickel? Is that any kind of way for an adult to conduct himself in a poker game, Stevens? What do you got?
Two pair.
Dermatologist and radiologist, the lowest of the low.
3 7s.
I can't stand it. I never win.
A boat.
Holy.
Sorry to win and run, gentlemen, but there's simply no competition here. Listen, Stevens, a word of advice. When you're playing with adults, do not raise a laxative.
I never win.
Coppers?
No, vitamin E.
Hi.
Hi.
You mind if I sit down?
Fine.
So, how's it going?
Fine.
Oh, good, good. And your life?
Fine. Mm-hmm. Saturday night, what are you doing here anyway?
Well, you might as well know. I guess everyone else does. I came to see you.
Oh.
Apparently, I'm wearing my heart on my sleeve. Haven't you noticed?
You've been very friendly. I appreciate that.
I see. You're not going to make this easy for me, are you?
10 years, Ben. So a lot of blood spilled in our relationship.
You still don't forgive me for leaving.
Oh, I forgive you. Sure. It's a lot harder to forget.
Look, if I could change what happened, what I did, you know?
I don't expect.
I mean, if I could, I would.
You're not listening, Ben. I forgive you. Really, I do.
You mean what I'm feeling? You don't feel anything like that?
Ben, I am crazy about you.
Well, wonderful. So, what's the problem?
I'm not crazy about you that way.
It's 10 years, Nance. I mean, I changed.
So have I. This were 10 years ago. I'd jump into bed with you right now.
Look, you know, you are throwing out very mixed signals here.
I'm trying to be as honest with you as I can.
Well,
I think you're irresponsible. Not to your work, but to people. I would have gone anywhere with you. I would have done anything. It took me a very long time to get to the point where you don't interfere with my living my life. And now you don't. I like my life. I like what I'm doing. I am perfectly happy.
I'm dying.
You won't die, Ben. I didn't. And besides, it'd probably be a big disappointment.
Not a chance. Now, you know that's not true, don't you?
I couldn't go through it again, Ben. I don't want to.
Still can't sleep, huh?
Not can't, won't. Too much to think about.
Yeah, well, I'll have them give you something to help.
Help me sleep or help me think? Really, I don't feel like sleeping. I think perhaps you're right after all. Maybe it's time I stop being a bird. I've been every species of bird known to humankind, and it still hasn't helped. The question is then, what should I be?
Well, that's a very good question, Ralph.
Maybe I'll just be myself.
I like that answer.
I thought you would. Well, it's a crisp, cool night. The kind that's better in Boston than any city in the world.
Give me a nice, warm breeze blowing in off the Gulf Coast anytime.
Too much humidity, Hugh.
Not for me.
What are you doing in Boston anyway, Hugh? You're like a duck out of water up here. I can see you in Mobile, Alabama, or Tuscaloosa, but you a Boston Brahmin?
I got sick of pawpaws.
Did you ever miss it? Gulfport, Mississippi, I mean.
Well, not the place so much. Mostly I miss my people.
Your folks still there?
Mm-hmm.
It's funny. I've spent so much time being angry at my folks.
How do you feel about them now?
I feel sorry for them. They've realized how badly they screwed things up.
Ralph.
No, please. I know. They weren't sure what to do with a kid who was supposed to be a genius.
They thought what they're doing was right. They were told that MIT was the best place for you.
I was 14 years old my freshman year. I didn't shave till I was 18. My parents never knew how to act around me. Now they can't bear to see me. So, I don't know how to act around them or anyone else for that matter. The only person who I ever felt comfortable with was Jane, the mother of my child.
Have you spoken to her recently?
I talked to her on the phone a week ago. She sounds happy. I feel happy for her. She's moving to Arizona.
Yeah.
I think being with her father's the best thing for her, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Things fall apart. The center cannot hold.
What's that?
It's from a poem by Yeats. Sort of describes my relation to the world. I don't know what to do with the world, and the world doesn't know what to make of me.
How are his pupils?
Sluggish.
His temperature's normal. That's not necessarily a good sign. The body's response to infection is to produce a fever. If there's no fever, it means he's not fighting off the infection. Any response to deep pain stimulation?
No. His pupils are dilated, but they're not fixed. They react only minimally to light.
Has he been decerebrating?
Yes. His brain's not active. It's obviously very infected. I don't understand. It's too fast. We're losing him.
He's not going to make it through the night, Jack. Better call the family.
I say that the breaking out of diseases like herpes 2 or Kaposi's sarcoma are nature's way of telling us to slow down sexually.
Is that your rationale for not having a date in the past 6 weeks?
Yeah, you laugh, but I got this friend Bob McConnell, and he found out he had chronic hepatitis.
Come on, Fiscus, what are you going to do?
Okay, keep your scrubs on.
Hey, any chance we get a seat in this game?
Sure.
The cards aren't going to change, Fiscus, no matter how long you look at them.
Okay, okay, I see your dime, and I raise your nickel.
Nickels and dimes? My grandmother doesn't play for nickels and dimes.
Yeah, well, that's what we get for playing with Larry, Moe, and Curly.
Ben, what are you doing in here?
Bury these.
Rumor mill has it you're out somewhere making time with Nancy Paxton.
She rejected him. I see your placebo and I raise you one. Jack it up.
Wait. What's this?
She told him to go hang his shingle elsewhere. Come on, let's talk more action, okay?
Is this true, Ben? Shakes my faith in something.
Yeah, Mighty Casey struck out.
Come on, you guys. I'm way down, and now you're fooling around. Give me a chance, will you?
What are you still doing here, Ben?
What? I just didn't feel like going home tonight.
I'm out. Fine, he's out. What are you going to do, Maverick? I call. Fine. Here, 3/8.
You're good, kid, but you're not good enough.
A flush? Do you just call me with a flush?
You're good now, Early.
Oh. My marker.
Fill this for me, Doctor.
Hello. Are you? Did you tell him we don't think Mickey's gonna make it?
Yes.
You sound like Joshua.
I'm an urgent fool, you and wait till I'm young.
They want to know if there's still any hope.
His heart rate's down to 40. He doesn't. I don't think so, no.
Doi bu qi, wo men she zai, mei you ban fa. I don't believe this.
What's he saying?
What was it?
Either
my Mandarin's getting weak, or he just said he wants to perform ultimate Chinese medicine on his son.
What is ultimate Chinese medicine?
It's an old Chinese superstition. Sometimes I use coins, candles. Spread it all over a room. I'm not sure. I've never seen it. It's the kind of thing you hear about when you're a kid.
But is there anything invasive? Needles or drops?
I'll ask. 我也蛮想知道, 才阳脚发，回把回龙泼到了皮肤。
不会，我们不会给他喝什么什么的，不会。主要祷告。
Santa, no, nothing that would upset your procedures. Sure. Why not? If it'll make him feel better. Tell him we've done everything possible.
Get 2 liters of plasma ink.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2
and two and three and four and five.
I'll do that. I need practice finding both chords.
Okay. I'm putting the femoral IV in place.
Is there any pulse yet?
Nothing. Still nothing. Can you see the chords?
No, not yet.
I'll do it.
No, I got it.
In here?
For breathing.
1 second. These pupils are fixed and dilated. Get me the thoracotomy tray. Stat.
Okay. Check for signs of breathing.
Put it in his stomach. Try again.
Need some gloves here. What do you got?
Chest wound with fecal contents coming from the abdominal cavity.
Where's the thoracotomy tray?
Burns is getting in.
Unbelievable.
I'm gonna get the massive discus.
All right.
Where's the tray?
It's moved. Okay, it's all set.
Give me the large knife. I'm going to open the chest.
You're retracted.
Oh, my God. There's no blood left in him.
Sicily.
Chest filled with blood.
I'm pulling the lung out of your way. Okay, I got the part.
Do you want the adar cross clamp?
No, scissors. I gotta cut in the pericardium. Let's see if I can squeeze the heart and pop some life back. Blood gasps. Come on, the blood gasps.
Okay, pH 6.9, PO2 40, PCO2 60, sodium bicarbonate 9.
There's no oxygen. I got a gunshot hole in the left ventricle. I have to close. Oh, Ethylon suture with Pledgett.
What?
Pledgett, Sam. Come on, listen up. Watch. I didn't have time to warm the blood. It's ice cold.
May help. With any luck, he'll become hypothermic and his metabolism will slow right down.
Give me 3 amps of bicarb, 2 amps of calcium gluconate, and a lidocaine drip, 1 to 100. Stat! Fiscus, cross-clamp the aorta distal to the carotid arteries. We've got to send as much blood as possible to the brain, otherwise he'll end up a vegetable. How long's he been here, anyway?
About 4 minutes. I'll tell him how long the flow's been cut off.
Carotid pulse.
Still nothing.
This boy's dead. God, he's not dead till I say he's dead. You understand? Where you been, Tennant? Getting a suntan?
Wait a minute. I'm getting something. I got a pulse.
All right. Okay, let's get him up to OR. I'm going to continue cardiac massage so we don't lose it. Okay. Let's move.
Some questions. Okay, what's his name?
I don't know.
Okay, you'll go down as John Doe till we find out who he is. What's your name?
Danny Cristiano. Junior.
Okay. Mr. Cristiano, do you want to tell me what happened?
I dropped a fare off at LaGrange. And we was out of town. I took him to a girly show or something. And so I'm coming back up the hill. And I noticed this younger guy talking to this older guy. But they're not arguing or nothing, just, you know, talking.
Mm-hmm.
And so I turned for a second to change the station on my radio. And when I look back up, the older guy pulls a gun out. And puts it right on the younger guy's chest. You know, like how you would put your finger on someone's chest? And then the younger guy turns away for a second, and the older guy shoots him, man, right in the back. I couldn't believe it. I've been working that combat zone for 5 years, and I thought I'd seen everything. I see hookers, junkies. I seen a guy one time just take a razor and just slice another guy's face up. But I never seen nothing like that. I got out of the cab and I went over and I pick him up out of the street, you know, and he looks at me and he says, "Why did they have to kill me?" Like as if he knew that he was dead. I ain't never held no dead person before. How the hell am I gonna get all that blood out of the back of the cab? I'm going to staple the left upper lobe of the lung, and then check out the liver, spleen, and kidney damage. See what we can repair and what we have to lose. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Staple gun. Here lies John Doe, unknown soldier of the inner city.
Remember when Saturday night used to be date night? Now you take your best girl to a double feature at the Bijou, catch a burger at the local mall shop,
try to cop a feel up at Lookout Point,
get her home by curfew. Now Saturday night rolls around, everybody's trying to blow each other's brains out.
Norman Rockwell dies hard.
Search and heal. Gonna be a long night. Suit you.
Doing that?
This egg represents a new life.
The egg signifies new birth. I'm making a halo around his soul.
It's gonna burn him.
It's okay, Jack.
Toss it out to a shot.
It's okay.
It's a poor way, Shanghai woman, urged her. It's a chin. Wait, one thing, Tati Ling Wen.
He says they're birth coins. Since they think the eyes are the mirror of the soul, the heat of the coins will reawaken the dormant consciousness.
They really think that's gonna save him? What do you think?
I think the boy has spinal meningitis. His cortex is nearly dead. I don't think he has a prayer.
Neither do I.
You don't believe in what they're doing?
Come on, Morrison. I grew up on TV dinners in the Celtics.
Well, I don't like it.
I've seen lots of things like this before, Jack. They don't do any harm.
I'm trained as a doctor, not as a faith healer.
He wants to know if it would be possible to remove the IV.
Sure.
Nancy, we can't remove his IV.
Jack, the boy is dying. It's not going to make any difference.
Did I tell you about Julius?
That paragon of pigeons?
Yeah, well, since you fixed him up, he is flying great.
That's fantastic.
I mean, I don't know what you did or how you did it, but he's flying record times.
Well, I'm always glad to help. Give my regards to Julius.
Well, what is this?
Just a little package I put together for you. Vitamins, oils, seeds, stuff like that.
No, I can't take this. This is your bird stuff.
No, Luther, I want you to have it. See, I'm getting out of the bird business. I'm retiring.
You mean you're not going to be a bird anymore?
That's right. I'm going to be a human 24 hours a day, every day. I'm even going to dream in human. Oh, come on, Luther. Don't look so sad. It's for the best.
Yeah, but Ralph, you were one hell of a bird. I mean, what happened?
Well, let's just say I've molted, lost my feathers, so to speak. There's no future being a bird anymore. I can't compete with Julius. I never could. Come on, take it. I bet your birds will love the stuff. I did.
Thanks, Ralph. Hey, Ralph. Listen, if you change your mind, I mean, if you decide to become a bird again, you can have it back.
to lose the spleen. Otherwise, I'm not going to be able to stop the bleeding. Ehrlich, catch that little bleeder for me, will you?
Ground control to Dr. Ehrlich. Hey, Ehrlich.
Oh, God, I'm sorry. Catch that little bleeder for me.
Where were you?
North Shore of Maui, inside a 20-foot curl. When I'm in here this long, I can't stop daydreaming. How do you still concentrate after 4 hours?
Are you kidding? This is it. Gets me off. We have enough 3-0 silk suture material left to do a temporary colostomy?
Yes, doctor.
Fanning on call?
Just finishing up an OR2.
Plan. Well, John Doe, looks like you're going to get a shot to get shot at again.
What do you think the fight's about?
Oh, who knows?
Draw the buck.
Listen, tell the delightful Dr. Fanning that we'll be ready for in about, 40 minutes. Repair damage to the left kidney. Hang in there, Ehrlich.
Ah, new blood. I don't think there's any left in the building. You pumped it all into John Doe.
Did he make it?
Too early to tell. Samuels has had him for almost 4 hours now. Jack, you want to sit in with us over here?
No, I'll pass.
You don't do that until you've looked at your cards.
Well, I've never been much of a card player.
We really could use a fifth man, Jack.
You realize you're taking food from my unborn child's mouth.
Oh.
Again.
Hey, man. 5-card, high, low, tap one to the right, and roll your own.
Game of a desperate man.
Just ante up, ante up.
Who dealt this mess? I only got 4 cards. Look, I got 6.
This deal.
Look, it's the best hand I had tonight. A low natural flush. I could have wheeled it and gone both ways.
Okay, okay. Heartbreak deal. Just toss them in.
Who's the deal?
They're in.
Mine. Who are Chinese?
Dr. Morrison?
What the hell?
I'm hungry.
Your headache?
Mm-mm.
How about your neck, Mickey? Does that hurt you?
Nope, just my stomach, because I was hungry.
Mickey, yeah. Mickey, 你问医生明天你可以不可以跟我们回家?
My parents would like to know if they could take me home tomorrow.
We'll have to run some tests first.
医生现在检查一下，没问题了。
Just as a precaution, just to make sure everything is really absolutely all right.
Taswa boya danshin. May wala sida.
Nidi chuan xin chuan yi gan woman lu li. Sentai ta meyo shirla. Xiexie ni. Ni shi yi ge hao yi xiang.
My mother and father would like to thank you. My father says that the spirit of children lives in the heart and mind, and that your intelligence with ultimate Chinese medicine rid my brain of the infection.
Mickey.
almost ready for you.
What do you have for me, Samuel?
We presented 5 hours ago to ER. With the left anterior thoracotomy, sutured the heart, and continued open heart massage on the way to OR.
Is he stable?
Well, relative to what he was, which was clinically dead. Haven't played any favorites with this one, Norma. Heart, liver, spleen, lungs, transverse colon, they've all had equal time. The only remaining injury is a laceration of the left kidney, and that means you.
Who is he, anyway?
Dr. Fanning? Meet John Doe.
Oh, Ralph, brings you down here at the crack of dawn.
I'd like some breakfast.
I'm sorry, Ralph, but they won't let me order them seats for you no more.
Oh, no more caraway seats for me. I want a big breakfast. Ham, eggs, bacon, and a short stack of blueberry pancakes with some real butter.
You want all of that, do you?
Man cannot live by worms alone.
Have you done that? You eat worms?
Yes, at one time in my life I did.
What did it taste like?
I don't know. It was a few years ago, just prior to my coming here. As a matter of fact, I never even remember eating them.
How do you know you did?
I was told by reliable sources.
Oh. Well, anyway, you're going to have to wait for all of that food. I haven't got to go up there. I got some coffee ready, though.
No, I don't think so. But how about a Danish and a large glass of orange juice? I'm feeling extraordinarily well this morning. You know that, Earl?
I'm good.
I haven't slept, but outside of that, it's a new day, a new dawn in the life of Ralph Selover.
You're feeling good, Ralph, ain't you?
Thank you, Earl. Thank you, my good man. My friend, mon ami très heureux. My very happy friend.
Yeah, that's me.
You are happy, aren't you, Earl? With your life, I mean.
Oh, of course I'm happy. There's nothing to be happy about. My pension's coming up. Me and my wife moving down south to the grandchildren.
That's terrific. That's wonderful.
Kids, great kids.
Just wonderful. Give them a kiss for me.
It won't be a while yet.
As a matter of fact, make that 4. Two on each cheek. Will you do that for me?
I will, Ralph. I will.
Thank you, Earl. See ya.
I repeated the lumbar puncture on Mickey Wong.
Uh-huh.
His Brzezinski sign is negative.
Good.
We should have an accurate read on him in an hour.
Okay.
Nancy, I'm sorry, but I... I mean, that boy was almost dead 2 hours ago. And now he's sitting up, eating pizza, as though nothing had ever happened. It is the single most amazing, wonderful thing I have ever seen. And yet you sit here as though it's an everyday occurrence.
As opposed to a miracle.
That's right. How can you tell me that it was the penicillin that cured him? The lumbar puncture showed pus 8 hours ago.
Do you have a more plausible explanation?
No. But I know what I saw. Ultimate Chinese medicine.
And you're going to write that up?
candles, burned coins, pink hard-boiled eggs arranged in a half moon on the pillow. Well, while you're at it, why don't you mention the spaceship we saw tonight? The blue-green glow, the music, unlike anything we'd ever heard. How incredibly friendly they were. You cannot write it up, Jack. The New England Journal of Medicine recognizes penicillin, not miracles. Especially when it's a first-year resident making a claim. You would lose all your credibility.
Then penicillin it is. Nancy. Just between you and me. What do you really think?
No question about it. It absolutely was a miracle.
I guess anything's possible.
I guess.
See the sunrise.
Oh, you did you?
Oh, I know. You're gonna go on about the rules.
That's right. I am.
Well, I'm sorry, but the view just isn't the same from my room. Buildings and bars, that's all I can see.
Well, okay.
Really, Hugh? Is it the truth or not? I mean, we've sat through quite a few sunrises down there together. Is it the pits or what?
It isn't the best view in the world, no.
Thank you.
We have some rooms that have better vantage points. We'll move you to one of those.
Thank you. I stand right there, Hugh. Thank you. Well, it should be a fantastic sunrise. Just enough clouds in the sky to make it colorful. Reddish pink. You think I'm gonna jump, don't you? Well, let me calm your anxiety. I'm not. But if I were, I wouldn't fall. I'd flutter. And I wouldn't light on the sidewalk. I'd land on a sailing mast bound for... Where was it, Hugh? Didn't it used to be Portugal?
Still can be. That was your dream.
That was ours. Jane's and mine. The ultimate migration. The quintessential flight. Birds of passage. Birds of the day. Of the night. Of dawn. The final roost, Hugh. The final roost. And now that's all gone forever.
Jane is not a bird anymore, Ralph.
I know that. I do. And I have my moments, too, when I realize that I'm not a... I have my moments, too.
I know you do.
I'm not an eagle, am I?
No.
And I'm not able to fly.
No, you're not able to fly.
I have these moments when I'm thinking clearly, like right now. And it makes it so hard. so devastatingly hard, Hugh, to accept my condition.
Time, Ralph. All you need is time.
You think so? You know, I don't think so anymore.
Come on, Ralph. Let's go back inside. Please.
Some night, huh?
Oh. Some night.
Did you know the patient who killed himself?
Ralph Sellover.
Why did he do it?
I'm not sure. Somebody said, trouble. The woman.
Well, I saw a miracle tonight.
Yeah.
A boy who should be dead right now is sitting up in his room eating pizza and complaining that he wants to go home.
I saw the same miracle. Different boy.
Jack Morrison said that after what he saw tonight, anything is possible. I thought you weren't working tonight.
Yeah, well, life's full of surprises, isn't it? You gotta be prepared to expect the unexpected.
I was never very good at that, was I? Why did you leave me, Ben?
I was young. And scared and shallow and very stupid.
You were the golden boy. Oh, you had the world at your feet.
Yep.
I remember you saying that you were going to be chief of surgery by the time you were 35. And not just at any hospital. Mount Sinai.
Yeah, well, that was a long time ago, wasn't it?
What happened?
Life. It threw me a couple of curves. Could never hit a curve.
Sure you could.
Could I?
Anytime. Anywhere. Do you still want the same things?
No, I don't think about that much anymore. You know, I used to see a closed door. I had to know what was behind it.
And now I walk by.
That's too bad.
Sunday morning.
Time to go home.
Ben.
Previously, and say it elsewhere.
I'm Dr. Paxton.
Hey, how you know so much about birds, Ralph? I am a bird, and now you walk back into my life, and it's like you never left.
Until we meet again, mon petit chou-fleur.
Oh, Dr. Bullfinch.
I will not have this man running around here playing doctor.
Tonight, and say it elsewhere.
Call the code, get an OR ready, tell him gunshot wound to the chest like you wouldn't believe.
10 years, Nance. I mean, I've changed.
So have I. This was 10 years ago. I jump into bed with you right now. He's not going to make it through the night check.
You mean you're not going to be a bird anymore? That's right. I'm going to be a human 24 hours a day, every day.
This boy is dead and gone.
He's not dead till I say he's dead.
Omni Premion.
They really think that's going to save him?
Yes.
You think I'm going to jump, don't you?
Come on, Ralph.
I stand right there, Hugh.
Thank you.
gave you the 50 cents?
Yeah.
And she says they all did. Oh, you know Mrs. Wilder? The one recovering in the burn unit?
Yeah, what about her?
Okay, she found her husband bed with another woman.
Looking can wait. This is paradise.
So what does she do? She's a real Einstein, this woman. She gets a gallon of gasoline, she douses them all with it, lights a match, and blows them all up. Take it easy, fella. So flash forward to the burn unit, okay? They're all bandaged up. They're all in these big dressings. They look like enormous cookie monsters, okay? And they just start wailing on each other.
Who?
Mrs. Wilder and the woman she found in bed with her husband.
Having no work to do.
They're in the same room together?
Right next to each other, beating each other up. Are you listening to my story?
Of course, sir. Like, I'm simply recapitulating. It's a rhetorical device.
His mind somewhere else. Dr. Paxton.
Oh, come, come, Dr. Samuels. You think we haven't noticed the glazed look, the heavy breathing?
Not to mention the fact you've been walking around here like Secretariat after he's put out the stud.
Or how your obnoxious, detached, patronizing manner melts into a rabid sexual yearning every time she enters the room. It's really quite touching for someone your age.
I haven't the vaguest idea of what you're talking about, Fiskus.
The truth. Wouldn't you like to take a tumble with Nancy Paxton?
Raise a nickel.
A nickel?
That's right.
I see your laxative, Lyle, and I raise you two firemen. You mean to tell me that you're here of your own free volition on a Saturday night?
Certainly.
Yes, I'm sure the fact that Dr. Paxton is on call has nothing to do with it.
You have nice hands, or like, you, want to be a surgeon?
What's the limit?
Morphine. Anything over the counter goes.
You mean I have to explain why I want to play cards with my colleagues of a Saturday night?
With your track record, Samuels? Yeah.
Listen to this. I'm going to sit here and take this kind of abuse from someone who has the nerve to raise me a nickel. A nickel? Is that any kind of way for an adult to conduct himself in a poker game, Stevens? What do you got?
Two pair.
Dermatologist and radiologist, the lowest of the low.
3 sevens.
I can't stand it. I never win.
A boat.
Holy.
Sorry to win and run, gentlemen, but there's simply no competition here. Listen, Stevens, a word of advice. When you're playing with adults, do not raise a laxative.
I never win.
Coppers?
No, vitamin E.
Hi.
Hi.
You mind if I sit down?
Fine.
So, how's it going?
Fine.
Oh, good, good. And your life?
Fine. Saturday night, what are you doing here anyway?
Well, you might as well know. I guess everyone else does. I came to see you.
Oh.
Apparently, I'm wearing my heart on my sleeve. Haven't you noticed?
You've been very friendly. I appreciate that.
I see. You're not gonna make this easy for me, are you?
10 years, Ben. So a lot of blood spilled in our relationship.
You still don't forgive me for leaving.
Oh, I forgive you. Sure. It's a lot harder to forget.
Look, if I could change what happened, what I did, you know?
I don't expect
I mean, if I could, I would.
You're not listening, Ben. I forgive you. Really, I do.
You mean what I'm feeling? You don't feel anything like that?
Ben, I'm crazy about you.
Well, wonderful. So, what's the problem?
I'm not crazy about you that way.
10 years, Nance. I mean, I changed.
So have I. If this were 10 years ago, I'd jump into bed with you right now.
Look, you know, you are throwing out very mixed signals
no,
here. That's...
I'm trying to be as honest with you as I can.
Well,
I think you're irresponsible. Not to your work, but to people. I would have gone anywhere with you. I would have done anything. It took me a very long time to get to the point where you don't interfere with my living my life. And now you don't. I like my life. I like what I'm doing. I am perfectly happy.
I'm dying.
You won't die, Ben. I didn't. And besides that, it'd probably be a big disappointment.
Not a chance. Now, you know that's not true, don't you?
I couldn't go through it again, Ben. I don't want to.
Spoil the mood.
Still can't sleep, huh?
Not can't, won't. Too much to think about.
Yeah, well, I'll have them give you something to help.
Help me sleep or help me think? Really, I don't feel like sleeping. I think perhaps you're right after all. Maybe it's time I stop being a bird. Been every species of bird known to humankind, and it still hasn't helped. The question is then, what should I be?
Well, that's a very good question, Ralph.
Maybe I'll just be myself.
I like that answer.
I thought you would. It's a crisp, cool night. The kind that's better in Boston than any city in the world.
Give me a nice, warm breeze blowing in off the Gulf Coast anytime.
Too much humidity, Hugh.
Not for me.
What are you doing in Boston anyway, Hugh? You're like a duck out of water up here. I can see you in Mobile, Alabama or Tuscaloosa. But you, a Boston Brahmin?
I got sick of pawpaws.
Did you ever miss it? Gulfport, Mississippi, I mean.
Well, not the place so much. Mostly I miss my people.
Your folks still there?
Mm-hmm.
It's funny. I spent so much time being angry at my folks.
How do you feel about them now?
I feel sorry for them. They've realized how badly they screwed things up.
Ralph.
No, please. I know. They weren't sure what to do with a kid who was supposed to be a genius.
They thought what they're doing was right. They were told that MIT was the best place for you.
I was 14 years old my freshman year. I didn't shave till I was 18. My parents never knew how to act around me. Now they can't bear to see me. So, I don't know how to act around them, or anyone else for that matter. The only person who I ever felt comfortable with was Jane, the mother of my child.
Have you spoken to her recently?
I talked to her on the phone a week ago. She sounds happy. I feel happy for her. She's moving to Arizona.
Yeah.
I think being with her father's the best thing for her, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Things fall apart. The center cannot hold.
What's that?
It's from a poem by Yeats. Sort of describes my relation to the world. I don't know what to do with the world, and the world doesn't know what to make of me.
How are his pupils?
Sluggish.
His temperature's normal. That's not necessarily a good sign. The body's response to infection is to produce a fever. If there's no fever, it means he's not fighting off the infection. Any response to deep pain stimulation?
His pupils are dilated, but they're not fixed. They react only minimally to light.
Has he been decerebrating?
Yes. His brain's not active. It's obviously very infected. I don't understand. It's too fast. We're losing him.
He's not gonna make it through the night check. Better call the family.
I say that the breaking out of diseases like herpes 2 or Kaposi's sarcoma are nature's way of telling us to slow down sexually.
Is that your rationale for not having a date in the past 6 weeks?
Hey, you laugh, but I got this friend Bob McConnell. And he found out he had chronic hepatitis.
Come on, Fiscus, what are you gonna do?
Okay, keep your scrubs on.
Hey, any chance of me getting a seat in this game?
Sure.
The cards aren't gonna change, Fiscus, no matter how long you look at them.
Okay, okay, I see your dime, and I raise your nickel.
Nickels and dimes? My grandmother doesn't play for nickels and dimes.
Yeah, well, that's what we get for playing with Larry, Moe, and Curly.
Ben, what are you doing in here? Bury these. Rumor mill has it you're out somewhere making time with Nancy Paxton.
She rejected him. I see your placebo and I raise you one. Jack it up.
Wait. What's this?
She told him to go hang his shingle elsewhere.
Come on, let's talk more action, okay?
Is this true, Ben?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this kind of shakes my faith in something.
Yeah, Mighty Casey struck out.
Come on, you guys, I'm way down and now you're fooling around. Give me a chance, will you?
What are you still doing here, Ben?
What? I just didn't feel like going home tonight. I'm out.
Fine, he's out. What are you gonna do, Maverick?
I call. Fine, here, 3/8. Good kid, but you're not good enough.
A flush? Do you just call me with a flush?
You're good now, really. Oh.
My marker.
Fill this for me, doctor.